The best days that Allah created, that's a hadith of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. The best days that Allah created, that He loves the good deeds in them, is these 10, al-ashr, and He called it al-ashr. And that's why the verse, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas comes and says, wal-fajr wa-layalin ashr, by the dawn, by the 10 nights, are these. Scholars differ. This is why I want you to give me your heart. They said they are even, some groups says they are even these days, the days are better than last 10 days of Ramadan. And some says the days are better than the last days of Ramadan, and the nights of Ramadan better than the last nights of Ramadan. And the third group, they say they are equal. The hadith was that Sahabi, the companion, asked the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, not even jihad fi sabilillah, not even somebody went for fighting for the sake of Allah and did not come back, died. And he said, not even that. So don't take it lightly. This is why I want to remind everybody, myself, number one. And if you are, which I'm sure majority of you, in groups, remind each other. We remind each other of a lot of things. Remind people about this. Because when you live in the West, you don't know it. You know, because nothing changes, except when is Eid, when is Arafah. That's good, alhamdulillah. Most of probably is going to be Friday, Arafah, and Eid is Saturday, or Saturday and Sunday, Allah knows. But the point is, remind each other, number one, every text you send to people to remind them of a good deed, it's a good deed for you. Let alone the person, if he did it or she did it, not only they will get the reward, you will get the reward also. So you will get the reward of sending it, reminding, and you will get the reward of someone doing the good deed. And what is the best good deeds? Is done in these days. It's a dhikr. It's a dhikr in these 10 days. In general, every good deed is a good deed. Because he said, al-amal al-salih. He said, good deed. But then when you see the actions of the Sahaba, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar is very well known, Ali. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar and Sayyidina Abu Huraira used to go together and enter into the malls these days. They call it market. To do what? Not because there's a sale. Not because let's go and buy, let's go and have a coffee. Only one reason. They enter from one door and they exit from another door to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to remind people. And they used to say it loud. They call it at-takbir al-mutlaq. These 10 days you say Allahu Akbar. Anytime, everywhere, in your home, in your room, in the car, at work. If you are not working in a Muslim place, then at least inside you. And then when the Eid starts, comes in, they call it At-Takbir Al-Muqayyad, where you start saying Allahu Akbar after every salah. You see it. If you come to Masajid, even here, they will do it. So don't forget this. Make sure you have a list of good deeds, of good deeds. Everybody is different. Some people can't fast. It's very difficult. They see it. And it is not easy. Some people can fast, but they cannot do Qiyam al-Layl. Some people can't do Quran, whatever. Put a list of good deeds with you and Allah. And don't forget the second group. What I'm gonna say. The good deed between you and people. Don't forget this. Good deed is not only between me and Allah, it's between me and you and me. Forgive, pardon. This is huge good deeds. We don't look at it as a good deed. You can't fast. Forgive somebody who have wronged you. That's a good deed. Give, be generous. You can't give money. You don't have enough. People are different. You can smile. You can make someone happy. You can help someone even by a good word, by a text. How are you feeling this morning? Right? The best deed, I see it, reflect around you. And look at the beauty of Allah's creation. Mountains. How many of you look at the mountain and think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And then remember the verse when Allah said in Surah Maryam, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ. They ask you about the mountains. They ask you, what is going to happen to them? فَقُلْ يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفًا. Tell them, Allah will destroy them. Allah will make them like earthquake. فَيَذَرُوهَا قَاعًا صَفْصَفًا. It will become ashes and like a plain earth. That's a tafakkur. You look at a bird, you look at the weather. It's very nice to talk to people who doesn't live in the same place because they see things you don't see it. The changes of the weather in one day here. You wake up in the morning, especially these days, and what do you see? a lot of fog. I mean, the other day, I couldn't drive. Literally, I couldn't drive. I had to stop. And then after an hour or two, the beautiful sun and the beautiful breeze. And then by 12 or 1 o'clock, very hot. Ya Allah, right, 90s. And then by before sunset, beautiful breeze, the beautiful sun, this creation of Allah. This is all signs of Allah. This is not you and me. This is ibadah. This is act of worship. So make sure you all do this. Khatma of Quran, it's like Ramadan. Do your best to read. Read, if you can finish one, you can finish two. If you are not yet comfortable with finishing, at least pick up a couple of ayah and understand what Allah is saying. And kabbiruha, that's why it's when you عظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب. Allah said it in Surah Al-Hajj, in the chapter of Hajj. This is time of Hajj, by the way. We don't feel it because we're not there. But these are the days of Hajj. And Allah said in Surah Al-Hajj, in between, talking about the Hajj itself, is anyone, woman, anybody, glorify the symbols of Allah is a sign of your taqwa. And the 10 days of the Hijjah is symbols of Allah. Why the 10 days? Allah chose it. Why not the 10 days of Shawwal? That's why it's my taqwa. I submit to Allah. Don't forget, for those of you who can't fast the whole 10 days, the day you do your best to fast is Arafah. Arafah. It will wipe the sins of the year before. And it's only for the people who are not on Hajj. The Hajjis, they are not supposed to, actually, at all. SubhanAllah. Because the ibadah of Arafah, when you are there, the act of worship when you are there, is. May Allah invite us. I still didn't lose hope. Very unlikely, but you never know. What is the act of worship on day of Arafah if you are there? Dua only. You only make dua. There's no salah. Actually, in fact, salah is combined and shortened. Yep. May Allah invite you all. There's nothing. It's only dua. He stood, alayhi salatu wasalam, from after salatu dhuhr. He did it together. He gave a khutbah. He gave a sermon. Till the sunset. On his qaswa, raising his hand, making dua. It's about 4 or 5 hours. We cannot do 5 minutes dua. The point, I'm trying to remind you because by next week, if Allah give us life and I'll meet you, the ashar already entered. So take advantage. It's not time for having fun or doing this or doing that. It's exactly like 10 nights of Ramadan. If not even, as I said, some say it is more. So make a covenant with Allah. Do your best to act differently. Even dress differently. Literally, dress differently for Allah. More pleasing to Him. Alhamdulillah, we all do that, but let's do it even more. You know what I'm saying? And I say this to myself before anyone. أَرِ اللَّهَ خَيْرًا مِنْكِ The best, show Allah the best of you. You know when you get invited to somewhere, or somebody is coming to your home, and you're so happy, and you want to show them the best? We all do that. Do this in the 10 days, inshallah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم